Okay, so here's the thing. Now, as I promised you, I just mounted a new tire. This meant there's a lot of meat here, so that's great. I must say that I definitely can feel the improvement with the traction. This thing basically eats everything. But I must say also that when I'm trying to slide, it's kind of difficult because it's trying to, you know, to hold the ground, and it won't let you slide that easy. Also, I told you I need to replace the axle, the rear axle. So here, guys, it's a new rear axle. This is the default one. Okay, nothing, not expandable or adjustable or anything else. I also changed this rear sprocket hub. Okay, mine was torn. So that's it, I guess. I'm really happy with those tires. Also, I do feel a bit of power, or just maybe because I didn't ride for a long time, or I can't say, but that's fine by me, because I really feel the difference, or I don't know how to call it. Every month, guys, I try to ride. I only have something like half an hour until the sun will go down and the dark side will rise.
Continue.
37 or 38 degrees and it's almost sunset. In the noon it was something like 42 Celsius. Very hot, guys, and I'm with a full body protector and shit, so I sweat like hell. Yeah, I got enough for the time we have, so it's okay. Let's set it back. Thank you. by the way, those are the GBC XC-Masters. Front are 22 on 7, the wheel size is 10. Rear, the wheel size is 9, and those are 20 by 11. I think it's something like 7. I'll fix this later. So that's it, guys. I really like my quad. I do think that I need to try some polish on the plastic, because maybe the previous owner didn't save it a lot and the fuel light just came on, so I need to fill up the tank. Hope I'll get it. Start. That's my first time that I having my fuel light warning light up, so turn on, sorry. So I don't know how much distance I can ride with this amount of fuel. I don't know why I thought I had enough. Maybe not. For sure not. Lesson learned. Don't be late. Okay, so actually in Israel it's not legal to ride on a bike without a number and, I don't know, like a cage, a protection cage for the quad. So basically my quad is illegal and there is a police guy it up with a full tank. It's cost 55 to 60 Israeli new shekels, and US dollar is something like 13 bucks. So that's okay, not pricey at all. However, I do want to make this quad legal, but I can't because it will mount the protection, the cage something, the protection cage here. It's like a pole, two poles, like here, going that high, okay? And the problem is, it is mount to the chassis, to the tail chassis. So basically, it's taking all of the balance of your quad out, and it's very dangerous. That's why I'm not mounting it, and that's why I'm not putting a number, license number, because if I do, they can take a picture of my license plate and, you know, get to know me personally. So I don't want it to happen. I really don't want to go. Okay, I think I need to... No, I have enough coolant. Liquid. So I'm really happy with the new tires. I'm keep repeating it, but I really am. Right now I'm trying to save some money because I'm spending a lot of money on this quad. The rear axle cost here in Israel $500. That's crazy. And this is the original one, this one, not any durable or anything else. So basically, I don't know, I wish I can afford myself to get this protection cage. Ah, by the way, another thing it's doing to the chassis, it's breaking the tail chassis, and then you basically cannot do anything with the quad, so you just can sell it for parts. It sucks. Oh, come on, go away, man. Just want to get my... So we don't have a lot of time. Right now it's 7 p.m. We have like until 7:20, I think. I don't know if we take a risk and go and fill out the